I am Dr. R.K. Verma, Professor of Department of Orthopedics. Today, we are going to talk about the knee joint degenerative arthritis. The disease which is a degenerative in nature, with the age it happens. So, this deteriorates the life quality. So final treatment for this degenerative disease is arthroplasty, because the conservative line of treatment fails, then only left treatment is joint replacement. So as denoted on the slide, we are going to talk about arthroplasty. So now you can see on the picture that these are the places where the deterioration of the articular cartilage, and if you see here, the articular cartilage has given way, but at the same time the pressure goes to the bones and it also creates to the cartilage of a patella. So slowly that stage proceeds and progress and deteriorate in that. So loss of cartilage shows in real life that these are the cartilaginous patches which has lost due to that degenerative changes. So this is the most common cause, and the abnormal knee joint is a function results for that. Sometimes it's a minute fractures in that. Ligaments are also affected, and it is a aging process. So final treatment, the indication for surgery, pain and disability at the point when daily living life become problematic, that is a surely indication. And the answer is artificial joint, resurfacing cartilage and underlying bone. There are varieties in that, metal and a plastic implant, and with that we also correct the deformity. So you can see in the picture that we have resurfaced the lower end of femurs, the cartilage part has been removed and replaced by a metallic hand, and the simultaneously this is upper end of tibia, this is a polypropylene thing which helps in mobilization of this, and this is the final x-ray picture in AP view, and this is final x-ray picture in lateral view. The objective of doing arthroplasty of knee joint to achieve the stability, painless motion, and putting this implant, because we have resurfaced the articular cartilage, which is a generation of a pain, so the motion becomes painless, and as the technique has improved, so stability also very high. To achieve long term fixation implant, we use the cementing process so that the implant should fix. And then while we are choosing an implant, we also correct the deformity, and if need deformity is much more, then we supplement in implant to reduce the correct the 100% deformity correction. And as the implant's quality has improved, that will reduce the wear and tear of which we are putting polypropylene support. So that so history of the TK is the, as it is shown in your slide, it is right from the 1863 to 1921, the joint interposition of capsule used to be put to give a smooth movement painlessly. And then the Ollier came and he put the muscle. Then Murphy came, he advised to put the fat and fascia. And Campbell, he put the pig bladder, but they have not achieved sufficiently. Then era of 1951 to 1958, this is a new era which has acrylic has come in, and later on it switched to the vitellium femoral hemiarthroplasty as Campbell has started doing it. In knee joint, acrylic two-part prosthesis first time came by Judet. Metallic tibial hemiarthroplasty was then for the hip joint, and metallic hinge was also there. So later on, as development is going on, research are going on, and today the era of tibial unicompartment design has come, and this is very good implant which reduces the wear and tear and increase the tibial this stability and give a good function near to the normal knee joint. 1969 polycentric TKA has come by Gunston. 1970, this is the sacrificing arthroplasty, freedom and the so on sons came. And in 71, Gooper has come with refined hinge. Then 72-74 polyethylene metal bicondylar anatomic TK has come, which was not very successful at that time. Then further things are, Coventry has come with a geometric design. Then unicondylar, unicompartmental arthroplasty, Boston and Birmingham has developed that one. And ultimately, the total condylar crusade sacrificing tricompartmental TKA, Hinsal has, and Dr. Ranawat, which is Indian in origin, has developed. This was the most successful design at that era, right? So, in 1975 to 1978, this bicruciate retaining metal back tibial TKA is the time of doing these things. Then varus valgus anterior posterior constraint TKA, Walker has started doing this. Then there was also, Hinsal has suggested that the posterior stabilization of the tibial component. In 1980, low contact stress ACL sparing component has come, which was very much successful. Even long term it has been, even today people are using it. The development of TKA, as we have already discussed, in 1970, 300 designs are there, and it has, its aim is providing a better mobility and reduce the wear and tear. You can see the photographs, congruity, femoral tibial articulation, large area of contacts, reduce the stress. That was the main goal to redesign things. And the photographs which are showing, these are the very important things. You can see LCS, low contact, stress, these are further developments are there. So we'll continue this thing further next time.